Greetings and salutations, exiles. This video we're going to discuss melee damage meta, kind of what is becoming the new powerhouse or the new kind of the go-to, because you know spears kind of have been nerfed, or anything new that comes out has been reduced in damage. Like, you used to see damage rolls or damage on, they say health damage is how it would be portrayed in the tooltips. Just for you that are not aware, tooltips is typically the like, if I select my daggers, tooltips is the bottom left corner here. Is, you know, usually if you have a pop-up, like it says dragon daggers, when it pops up, that's a tooltip also. And speaking of which, I wish if I had moused over something, it would give me those stats in the mouse over, and also maybe here as well. You know, kind of flesh out, besides just having the name, flesh it out in the tooltip. But back to my original, I drifted a little bit there, but back to my original topic, you know, when they come out with new items now, daggers, before you would see them 49, 52, you know, maybe 50, 55. But now you're starting to see daggers usually kind of in the range of like 39, 42. So they've rolled back spear damage. They've rolled back spear damage. I showed you dagger, so I just assimilated that word. I meant to say spear damage by something like 10 to 15%, because they wanted to change the meta. They wanted to change the meta significantly and get away from now weapons are more role purpose. And I've noticed that the daggers has quickly become the new meta, but they don't work well on thralls at all. It's strictly a PvP scenario. And, you know, if you can get the poisons and the bleed, especially with the new scorpion poison, it's such a powerful thing. You can strip half the life off of somebody with one combo. And but the problem is with thralls, you know, is if you have a thrall with you when you go into PvP, he's going to also attack all your allies. Like, he doesn't distinguish or separate the two, and so you run into issues where you almost can't take the thrall if you're in a kind of a joint raiding party or a joint group. And I was thinking about that today. We did kind of a little revenge raid. There had been a clan on our server where they would just go around and kill on site everybody, and they would raid everybody, and they just ultimately a bunch of jackasses. Like, they had no code of conduct. You don't, not to say necessarily you need to have a code of conduct in exile, but you know, a big part of any political situation is you develop alliances. So, you know, a lot of us kind of have developed alliances, and these ass clowns were just rolling around on the server just wreaking havoc and deleting a lot of people's work. So we collectively just deleted them is what we did. And I recorded some of it. I only got like the last 20% of the raid on video, but I realized that having the thrall there was kind of a disaster, because the thrall kept running after friends and stuff, and I'm like, oh, like, this is so annoying. And so thralls, you know, PvP and thralls, thralls are only really good for in a PvP scenario. If you're running solo, comma, in a base defense scenario, as a base protection, that's really where thralls come into play. Because if you know you're by yourself, you know, then it's a valid resource. But if you're in any kind of group scenario, it just turns out it's such a pain in the ass. I kind of wish they would do flush out the clan system, or you could tag players, somehow mark players for neutral, and they would just leave them alone. And that way the thrall AI just wouldn't be a disaster all the time. I kind of wish something like that existed, because it's just a hot mess. And one of the things, back, you know, kind of back to the new meta, is daggers have become, you can't say one, you know, one weapon rules them all. It now are much more isolated or niche. So daggers have become the new meta in the the PvP realm, especially with the daggers that come out of the sunken city. Those daggers do 53 damage without a weapons kit, and that'll bump them to 57, I believe. And it's just so much raw damage. Plus, you start t stacking bleeds. It's just so efficient. But for two-handed weapons, the thrall meta for two-handed weapons is swords. And I watched a couple, kind of back to my original topic. I watched a couple of videos, and people are just like the kind of the mainstream Conan Exiles YouTubers. I don't want to say any names, but they did a video on the Annihilator. The deal, and I've tested all of this stuff extensively. I've taken each weapon, fought the same boss 5 times, written down all the times that it takes to kill that boss, document it all, and you come to conclusions. And what I figured out is the Annihilator that comes off that boss, that second boss that drops the arena key. That Annihilator is really kind of a niche weapon, and it is designed specifically to kill the champion, and that's it. Because when you use that Annihilator on, let's say, the Red Mother, Dragon, or you use that Annihilator on the Bat Boss, it actually is a slower, that takes longer to kill that boss. Versus using a Dragonbone two-handed sword. A Dragonbone two-handed sword will outperform that weapon in every other scenario except the champion. And they've kind of gone in there and retooled that boss to for whatever reason, it has like an additional armor stat that most bosses don't have, and you can tell because if you go in there, let's say with a Dragonbone sword, it'll take like 20 minutes to kill her, and she'll even if you have a thrall with 7,500 hit points, she'll just cut right through all that HP, and you'll be busting out healing arrows. But if you put that Annihilator on her, that your thrall will cut her down in less than 2 minutes, and it's specific to that boss. And so I just wanted to share that with you because, some of this other YouTube content is really, really kind of fecal in nature. Like it's just like, here's your epic item, here's where you get it. It's the best, and they don't speak to anything on systems. They don't speak to anything on how anything works. It's a 3-minute video, and it's kind of lacking in knowledge and understanding of how the game actually works. And I just kind of wanted to broaden that a little bit to help help the people who have subscribed to me. I mean, obviously they prefer kind of a more in-depth type of knowledge base. And this content is obviously kind of meant to be listened to as a podcast. But yeah, some of these videos, you can tell that they play on single player game, and they don't actively play on real official servers. With the rule set that exists, because I think they're deriving some of their opinions strictly off of a single player modded server or a single player existence only, and that is a far different experience than playing on an official PvP server. Anyways, as always, like and subscribe. And I know I ramble a little bit, and sometimes I shift directions in thought, but I feel it's important to kind of share with you some insight. And maybe kind of develop your understanding of some of these systems or terminology to broaden and generally improve your overall playing experience is my goal. And ultimately, check out the Wishlist series. I'm going to start posting some of this stuff on the forums. I've generally had a negative experience with the Funcom forums. I wish they had more developer participation. They have some moderators, but you can tell that they're snowflakes. You can totally tell that they're snowflakes with kind of a an agenda, or should I say they're easily offended. They block stuff all the time, and you're like, I'm articulating a problem that needs to be fixed, and it gets blocked. It's so frustrating. So, as always, criticism is welcome. Any commentary, any type of criticism, even haters, man. Haters are awesome too. So always like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.